Do you want to know who would be more likely to win a possible one-on-one fight between the Wolverine and the Clouded Leopard? In this video we will compare these two animals to find out the answer to this question. The Wolverine, also called Glutton, Carcajou, or Skunk Bear, is a member of the weasel family that lives in cold northern latitudes, especially in timbered areas, around the world. The Wolverine is known to be strong and vicious and is said to have immense strength in comparison to its size. Wolverines are strong, stocky, bear-like animals with extremely powerful jaws that can crunch through frozen meat and bone. The Wolverine also has long, sharp, powerful claws that he uses to catch its prey and to defend itself from predators and other wolverines. The Wolverine also uses its claws for climbing and digging. It has long, dense fur that doesn't retain much water, making it very resistant to frost in the Wolverine's cold habitat. They are black or brown in color with a pale brown band down each side, a long tail, and they have been known to give off an extremely strong and unpleasant odor. The pungent odor has given rise to the nickname Skunk Bear and Nasty Cat. Wolverines, like other mustelids, possess a special upper molar in the back of the mouth that is rotated 90 degrees, towards the inside of the mouth. This special characteristic allows wolverines to tear off meat from prey or carrion that has been frozen solid. Wolverines are the largest member of the weasel family and they are the second largest mustelid, giant otters being the largest. The adult wolverine is about the size of a medium dog, with a length usually ranging from 26 to 42 inches, a tail of 6.5 to 10 inches, and a weight of 12 to 55 pounds, though exceptionally large males can weigh up to 71 pounds. Wolverines are highly territorial animals and they will fight other wolverines to defend their territory. Even if they are considered to be primarily scavengers, wolverines are also powerful and versatile predators. Whether eating live prey or carrion, the wolverine's feeding style appears voracious, leading to the nickname of glutton, also the basis of the scientific name, Gulogulo. A solitary animal, it has a reputation for ferocity and strength out of proportion to its size, with the documented ability to kill prey many times larger than itself. The wolverine uses its large teeth and powerful jaws to crush large bones and eat meat that has been frozen in the unforgiving Arctic winter. Wolverines often pursue live prey that are relatively easy to obtain, including animals caught in traps, newborn mammals, and deer, including adult moose and elk, when they are weakened by winter or immobilized by heavy snow. Prey mainly consists of small to medium-sized mammals, but the wolverine has been recorded killing prey such as adult deer that are many times larger than itself. Wolverine eats almost anything, his list of prey is almost endless. Sometimes the wolverine kills even smaller predators, such as martens, mink, foxes, Eurasian lynx, weasels, and coyote and wolf pups. Wolverines have also been known to kill Canadian lynx in the Yukon of Canada. The wolverine's diet also includes eggs, roots and berries. The wolverine is very quick and can run at speeds of up to 30 miles per hour when chasing its prey. The wolverine also pounces on its prey from trees. The wolverine stores its food in caches to eat later. It sprays its caches of food with a stinky musk that keeps other animals away. The aggressive wolverine has been known to drive bears, cougars, and packs of wolves from their kills. The clouded leopard is a medium-sized wild cat, occurring from the Himalayan foothills through mainland Southeast Asia, into southern China. This species, like the snow leopard, is one of those that is somewhere between the small cats and the great cats in that it can't purr like the small cats, and it can't roar like the true great cats. Clouded leopards prefer to live in lowland tropical rainforests. However, they can also be found in dry woodlands and secondary forests, and in Borneo, they are reported to live in mangrove swamps. It is also called mainland clouded leopard to distinguish it from the Sunda clouded leopard. It is the state animal of the Indian state of Meghalaya. They have a tawny or gray-colored coat with large irregular-shaped rings that look like clouds, hence their name. They are stockily built, with short legs, large paws, and a long, narrow skull. Clouded leopards are medium-sized cats. Their body length is between 26.5 to 43 inches, their tail length is between 23.5 and 35.5 inches, and they weigh between 35 and 51 pounds. The tree-climbing talents of the clouded leopard rival that of the margay. Fitting for an arboreal creature, clouded leopards are one of the best climbers in the cat family. They are able to climb upside down underneath tree branches, hang from branches with their hind feet, and even descend head first, like a squirrel. Several adaptations allow clouded leopards to achieve these amazing arboreal skills. Their legs are short and stout, providing leverage and a low center of gravity. Furthermore, a clouded leopard's extremely long tail provides an excellent balancing aid. For grip, their large paws are armed with sharp claws and specialized padding that conforms to the shape of the branch. The hind feet possess flexible ankle joints that allow the foot to rotate backwards as well. Clouded leopards can easily jump up to 3.9 feet high, and are also quite adept at swimming and readily take to water. Another distinctive feature of the clouded leopard is its long canine teeth and unusual skull. The clouded leopard has the longest upper canine teeth for its skull size of any modern carnivore, causing some people to compare the cat with the extinct saber-toothed cat. In fact, studies by Dr. Per Christensen of the Copenhagen's Zoological Museum have revealed connections between the two groups. Both saber-toothed cats and clouded leopards have an enormous gape, around 100 degrees, and various adaptations to support such a gape. In contrast, a modern lion can open its mouth about 65 degrees. This could indicate that one lineage of modern cats, of which now only the clouded leopard is still present, evolved some adaptations in common with the true saber-toothed cats. It also indicates that the clouded leopard may hunt large prey in the wild in a slightly different manner from other great cats. Saber-toothed cats would bite prey through the neck, using their elongated teeth to sever nerves and blood vessels and strangle the windpipe, which would instantly kill the prey. This was a very different hunting technique from living big cats, which use a throat or muzzle grip to suffocate the prey. It is possible that clouded leopards use a similar technique. However, little is known about clouded leopard hunting strategies, and no current evidence points to an unusual feeding ecology. Although a relatively small predator, a clouded leopard can take down sizable prey because of its strong legs, large canines and extreme gape, ability to open mouth to about 100 degrees. Clouded leopards are carnivores, and their diet mainly consists of birds, monkeys, deer, porcupines, wild boar, pigs, young buffalo, and domestic livestock. When hunting, they stalk their prey or wait for the prey to come to them. After making and feeding on a kill, they usually retreat into trees to digest and rest. So, who will win this fight? First of all, because it is a very balanced fight, and any advantage in size or weight would tip the balance decisively in favor of one of the fighters, I will specify that the two fighters will have the same weight, namely 45 pounds. The wolverine has the advantage of superior strength and stamina. The clouded leopard, on the other hand, is faster and more agile. I will not dwell on the differences between the main weapons, claws and teeth, of these animals. The important thing is that both can cause fatal injuries. I never hid from you the fact that I believe that cats are the most effective killers in the animal world. But this fame they have gained is largely due to the fact that they are masters of camouflage and ambush. They are not endurance fighters, they get tired quite quickly, and if they do not manage to apply the decisive blow quickly, they have great chances to lose the fight. In addition, while our cat is the typical professional killer who acts according to the textbook, the wolverine is the bully specialized in street fighting, who will not hesitate to hit under the belt, or spray you with pepper spray in the eyes. Moreover, the wolverine has experience in dealing with other cats. There are documented cases in which it manages to kill Eurasian lynx, cats that weigh an average of about 46 pounds. That being said, I think Wolverine is more likely to win this fight. As usual, I am waiting for your opinions in the comments. Thank you for watching and please hit the like button, and share this video with your friends if you liked it. Stay safe.